Tristan, where are we going tomorrow?
New York.
Woohoo!
It's 4 a.m. and I'm tired, but that's okay. I've heard people freak out when they travel, and I've been there myself, especially as a bodybuilder who wants to make gains. When you're thrown off your routine or you're in a new environment, it can be scary because you wonder, is this going to set me back? But the truth is, bodybuilding enhances our lives. It's not supposed to take away from it or restrict us. It's supposed to make us better. So have a game plan, bring some extra protein, maybe plan to hit a training or two, and embrace life. Enjoy culture. When you travel, have their food. Spend time with loved ones. Don't stress. You're not going to lose gains in a week. So be present. Be with the ones that you love. Pause right there. Okay, Tristan.
What?
Are you super excited?
Yes, for the Super Mario movie.
All right, let me see. Mario movie was epic. We couldn't bring our phones in, of course, but let me tell you, I have never had a milkshake that tasted that good. I had a milkshake, I had a little bit of popcorn, I brought a little protein powder with me. That's my trick too. I sneak in protein powder places. I try to go ahead and pre-mix it and I just put it in my purse. I know it's harder for men, but you know, if you are a man, just get you a girl that understands and then you can put your protein in her purse. Eh? But seriously, the reason for having protein with, say, junk food, maybe you're going to have some candy, maybe you're going to a movie, you're going to have some popcorn. Protein synthesizes our nutrients. So as long as we're training regularly, and I'm not saying train every day while you're on vacation, but as long as you have a regimen, typically, you're working towards a goal, you're consistent when you're in your normal routine, when you're at home, then when you go out of town and say you go off your plan, you have some snacks, have some candy, experience the culture, just focus on hitting your protein goal. And don't try to add a bunch of unnecessary carbs and fats in there, because chances are, if you're enjoying the food where you're at, it already has plenty of fats and carbs. And if you're like me and you live in the South, then anywhere in the world you go is going to have healthier food than the places that I go around here. So my trick is always to have a protein with everything I eat, even if it's in the form of protein powder in a shake. Because, again, that's going to synthesize the nutrients. That's going to allow the carbs and the fats to be delivered to muscles for more muscle glycogen replenishment, as long as we've been training on a consistent basis. Now, if we haven't been training, we've been falling off our plan left and right when we're at home in our routines, then if we go on vacation and we eat like a jerk, I'm kidding, but really, if we eat off, you know, like crazy and we don't really train while we're there, we're basically just going to push ourselves more in the direction that we don't want to go. So the key is keep it tight when you can, when you're home, when you're on a routine. Just keep it tight. Don't even think about it. You know, focus on other things. Focus on family. Focus on your job. Focus on spiritual growth, whatever it is. and then stay in that routine of training, stay in that routine of eating clean. Then that way, when you go on trips, you can actually take a vacation without feeling guilty. But do keep your protein up. That'll help you hold on to muscle.
Pass out the shells.
Can I have a shell fry? We got wedge.
Oh, hurry.
Okay. Do you have enough hands?
Okay,
you got two.
You got two. How many do you have?
I've got one, but it's okay.
Well, here. It goes by whose throw is best.
It's okay.
I don't really
want to throw. I gotta open the door.
He feels guilty. Make it sneaky. As soon as you see him, deck him.
Hello. Is there a jaw?
Or is he?
What if he's exposed?
Is there a jaw? Mark, what if he's at the jaw?
Maybe we should let Morgan check.
Come here.
Is he exposed?
No.
Where was it?
John, come here.
Ah! We're such kids.
Fuck the attack.
When you come to the movie with us, you won't get decked.
Now it's time for the best part of the day, training. Now, base your workouts on how many days you're going to be training on your trip. Let's use a 5-day trip as an example. If you're planning to train as usual, go ahead and stick with your split. You might have to substitute some variations for different movements based on maybe your equipment availability. So swap out movements as you need to, but if you can train as often in the gym on vacation as you can at home, and you want to, your schedule allows it, then by all means, stick to that training schedule. That's gonna keep your head straight and it's gonna make you feel better throughout the day. But say you've got 2 days to train and you're on a 5-day trip, or you know, compare it to whatever your situation is. What you might wanna do is combine areas. So for example, I'm training 3 days on my 5-day trip. So I'm almost hitting all my days, but I am missing one. So instead of doing 2 separate leg workouts, I'm combining all my leg movements in one session. That way I can hit upper body push and upper body pull on the other days, incorporating arms and accessory work on those days as necessary.
So now when you train hard, you can use meals like this as a post-workout. So vacations do not have to set you back. That's all I'm saying.
Logie! Sweet boy!
Yes! I've always wanted to put a space in the apartment.
You better hurry, they're waiting.
Also, this makeup box is so cool.
Thanks. So.
That puppy.
So I got really excited because usually there's just like street food, you know, when you walk out, but
oh, come on.
They had whey protein that you could add to these shakes. So I got a strawberry, blueberry, what was the last thing? Lime smoothie with whey protein. It was pretty magical.
So to be clear, cardio might not be necessary to add in when you're on vacation, especially if you're doing a lot of walking, which typically we do when we're on vacation, unless we're just lounging by a pool. So I'm hitting my next workout here, upper body push. And one thing I wanted to note is vacations are an amazing opportunity to explore. You know you're going to be out of your normal routine, you're going to have different equipment,
So really, your numbers are going to be off if you do log your numbers, because the machines are going to be different. This is a wonderful opportunity to get creative. I find that I really break through mentally, and I'm able to create new things when I'm on vacation because I'm out of my normal routine. So here I am designing my next posing routine. Of course, it's got a long way to go, but by breaking out of my normal routine and giving myself a break from the mundane tasks, I unlock a level of creativity. So don't deny yourself that. Stop kicking yourself for not being on a perfect routine when you're away, and allow yourself to be creative when you're on vacation.
And that, my friends, is how you stay intentional about your goals while you're on vacation, while also living your life. Don't let bodybuilding hold you back. Don't let your goals keep you from experiencing new things. Just stay intentional, keep your protein high, stay active, and go kill it in this life.
Maybe we should get some blankets.
Rooftop at Aunt Mo's.
Whoop, whoop. Woo! Woo!